Hey guys, what's going on? It's Nathaniel Evans again. Welcome to my YouTube page, Nathaniel Daily Inspirations. And today my topic is actually going to be more about the magic of self-care. Like what self-care looks like. You know, is it money? You know, is it things? Is it purpose? Is it actually goals that you're actually seeking to have? Like what does it look like? You know, and this is really, really important to be able to identify. To see the importance of who you are is the beginning of self-care. Everything else does not measure. It does not add up to you. There's not a thing that you can actually obtain in this world that will actually give you self-care, that actually will identify you and allow you to be insatiable with the moment. Like, you know, you get to the point where you say, you know what? I don't need nothing else right now. I just got this thing right here. I actually got this woman. I got this man. You know, I actually achieved this goal for myself. And now it's nothing else that I actually need. It's not going to happen. Self-care is about you. What do you do with yourself? You know, how do you value yourself? And who are you in the moment? Who are you in real time? You know, who are you when people come up to you or talk to you and you walk down the street, the strangers? Like, what do they identify with you? What energy that you actually bring forth? And how do you actually bring that energy forth? This is the moment of self-care. Self-care is about you and you alone. Cultivating you so you can actually get to the purpose of doing things that actually satisfy you and increase you as an individual. That's the moments of self-care. Other things that you do is what you do. The thing that you possess because of who you are, they're possessed because of who you are. The energies that come to you for what you are and what you represent to the world is what you actually brought to you. If you went and got this job, it wasn't because you was lucky. It's because the energies of you exist within you is manifesting outside. People are taking notice of who you are. They're bringing life to you. I was just looking at a show the other day, and they basically talk about a man, he was actually plumbing. You know, he did a plumbing job in the bathroom, and he was singing a song. He was so excited, you know, that he got so excited in singing the song that the owner was actually a record producer of the house, and he actually gave him a record deal. This is self-care. To be you no matter where you're at, no matter what's going on, and telling you the truth, chaos is going to come at you all the time. Things that you not considered, things that you have not paying attention to, they're actually going to find you in your greatest moments. And what do you do now? How do you magnify yourself above these situations and stay true to your inner being to ensure that who you are is always at the forefront? It's important not to diminish your light because of any situation. It can be rent, it can be, you know, light, gas, it can be broken relationships, it can be severances with your children, you know, again, you actually, you just got, you know, people, a lot of people got cut off from unemployment, which is millions of people in the world, right? What do? Right? Do you get caught up in the moment that you actually lost your employment, you know what I'm saying, through unemployment? Do you actually lost, you know, your revenue source that you actually needed to survive? No, you pick up the pieces. You go within yourself and you bring yourself back out. You know what I'm saying? You reintroduce yourself back to the world. And you let people know, I'm here. I haven't gone nowhere. I might have been on the radar for a year because of COVID. But right now I'm here and it's things I need to do to bring self-care to me. And it's not about money. Don't get misconstrued that you think that self-care is about your money. It's not about your cars or anything else that you obtain in this world. Because all those things, you brought yourself to get those things through you. By having purpose for you and having enlightenment for your own life. We take time to increase other things in the world. You might write a proposal, or you might build a bike, or you might build a car. That takes process, and that takes care. That takes listening to the instructions that's given to you and follow them to a T, because if you know if this bike, something goes wrong with this bike, somebody can get home. If something goes wrong with this car, somebody else can get home. So it's actually following things to a T. How do you do the same thing with yourself? How do you follow yourself to a T? How do you increase who you are no matter what's going on? How do you do it? By getting into you. Self-care can be in the form of meditation. It could be in the form of taking long walks. It could be in the form of singing and dancing, you know, meeting strangers and just talking, right? And actually appreciating who you are every single step of the way, your flaws included. Your flaws is about you. It's things that you need to work on, or some things that you don't even pay attention to that others may have to point out that now you have to give your undivided attention to. And this is where self-care comes from. Understanding the different elements of you, appreciating the different elements of you, and cultivating those elements to the point that now you can bring you into the world, right? And you don't have no reservations about that. You don't have to be ashamed of who you are. You're walking in full confidence and full understanding, right? And you're ensuring yourself, you know what I'm saying, that, wow, this is me, man. You know, I really care about me. You know, what can I do more to make life better for me, right? How do I laugh in the morning? How do I wake up, you know what I'm saying, in great spirits? How do I go to sleep in great spirits, right? How do I treat my neighbors or strangers that I meet in the street with great magnitude of compassion, of empathy, and sometimes even sympathy? How do I do these things? By providing these same things to myself. This is how I do these things. I'm not above anything or anyone because I'm here. I'm a part of my life. I'm connected to my life source, and I actually see it in real time, and I love everything I see, regardless of who loves it or not. This is self-care. Not diminishing yourself for anything. They was actually looking at an article the other day where a woman, I think it's 2006, no, I just heard about it, but it happened 2006. She won, you know, $37 million, and she said that it destroyed her life. She's highly upset. She was highly upset. She was unhappy that she won $37 million, and many things went airy in her life, you know what I mean, to the point where she wound up losing her life at the age of 57, right? Money did not increase her. Money was not her self-care. It was not her magnitude. So do not instill yourself within a thing. Do not think a thing will actually increase you or make you have more purpose, because it will not. You know what I mean? No, you know what I'm saying? That your self-care is solely about you. And once you attach it to any type of form, I don't care what form it may be, you know what I'm saying? Anything that may be tangible, you lose parts of who you are, and those parts that you lost, it's not easy to get them back. Once you sacrifice them to a thing, you are you. You are your self-care. Don't look for you in anything. Don't think that anything that you find in the world will give you greater purpose or greater understanding. You know what I'm saying? Will magnify you above others. You know what I'm saying? Will increase you to heights that you've never known. Those same things that actually increase you can actually diminish you. So be aware of not to link yourself to any form or anything, you know what I'm saying, that will turn around and have ultimate power over you. You are your self-care. This is Nathaniel Evans. I'm glad y'all listened. I hope I can bring more understanding to different people, share more of myself and the gifts that I have, and they can also share their gifts with me. This is Nathaniel's Daily Inspiration. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. Have an amazing day and be blessed.